Hi everyone, welcome back to Simply Maker channel. In today's video, I'll show you how I revive a surprisingly affordable PD charger. I snagged it for just $2 from AliExpress. I originally picked up this charger for a test in my previous video, where I explored using a PD charger on an older laptop that uses a standard power supply. It turned out to be a lot better than I expected. Unlike other low-cost chargers with similar designs, it could genuinely output up to 20 volts at 225 amps. Most of the budgeted chargers I found tend to max out at 5 volts. However, there's a catch. When using both ports simultaneously, the maximum voltage drops to 5 volts. Nevertheless, considering its cost, it left me quite impressed. Sadly, the outer shell is just broken out. Upon inspecting the internal electronics, I discovered that only the plastic shell was damaged. Perhaps it took a fall or something accidentally fell on it while I plugged it into an outlet. So, I've decided to give it a second chance at life, by designing a new shell, and incorporating a rocker switch and an IEC 320 inlet. However, I recently discovered that this charger has been discontinued, and replaced with a newer model. The dimensions of the PCB, and the distance between the output ports used in this design, are illustrated in the following diagram. I'm unsure if the other versions have the same PCB dimensions. I've included a download link for STL files, along with the step file in case you have a similar charger, and need some modification. So let's see how I make it. Let's begin by preparing the power inlet. I've selected an IEC 320C8 inlet, which conveniently mounts to the shell using M3 screws. I'm using 18 AWG wires for the power input. I'll carefully solder them to both pins of the IEC socket. It's important not to overheat the pins, because the plastic casing of the socket doesn't handle high temperatures well. After making sure the wires are securely connected, I'll cover them with shrink tubes for extra protection. Now, let's include a rocker switch. I chose the KCD1 with 2-pole rocker switch for this. Connect a wire to one of the pins on the switch. This wire will be connected to the PCB later on. After that, position the IEC socket into the shell, guiding one of the wires from the inlet through the switch hole. Then solder this wire to another switch pin. Now it's time to secure the socket into the shell. I'll use 10mm M3 screws to secure it to the case using M3 nuts. Next, use a desoldering tool to remove the input wires from the PCB. This tool is one of my budget-friendly favorites. It makes a desoldering task a lot easier. If you're curious, you can take a look at my mini review. Then, I'll solder the wires from the inlet and rocker switch to the PCB. Place the PCB into the shell, ensuring it fits snugly within the provided slot. Use an M3 tab drill bit to make threads in all 4 holes on the top of the shell. Attach self-adhesive foam tape to the cover to ensure secure and stable placement of the PCB inside the shell. Close the cover and secure it with 8mm M3 screws. Finally, I printed the LED cover using clear color filament. Then I simply pressed it into the LED hole. You may also apply some glue from the inside of the shell. But in my case, it fits tightly without any additional adhesive. Once I completed assembling the charger and conducted some tests, I found out that I'm not so comfortable using it, with the ventilation grill holes on the cover. The holes sit directly above the high voltage AC inlet. In the end, I decided to cut a piece of transparent plastic sheet and glue it over the ventilation to enhance safety, rather than reprinting it with a modified shell. And there you have it. Even though the PD charger featured in this video is no longer in production, but I hope this video sparks ideas on how to repair and repurpose electronics using a 3D printer instead of discarding them. Choosing to fix and upgrade gadgets, rather than replace them, can contribute to reducing electronic waste, helping to save the Earth one device at a time. If you enjoyed this tech makeover, please give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and ring the notification bell for more DIY tech projects in the future. And if you have your own ideas or suggestions for future projects, drop them in the comments below. I love hearing from you and getting inspired by your creative thoughts. Remember, the downloadable files are in the description, so feel free to grab them if you're diving into a similar project. Thanks for joining me today. And until next time, stay curious, stay creative, and keep making.